closed up. Head up.
We opened the shop in a different location back in 95, so it's like 25 years ago, isn't it? And it was a little shop round the corner. And at the time, vinyl was kind of dead. And we did do CDs as well, but we did quite a lot of records. The main change really is, obviously downloads has affected probably some things, but probably not us, because people, the sort of records that we stock were always the sort of things that people wanted on record, they were vinyl collectors anyway. So the thing that's changed is now that at that time there was a lot of people more looking for CDs than looking for vinyl records. So we were buying like loads of people's collections of and things, and they were basically moving on to CDs. And it's changed almost, it's almost a full reversal now, where people have now, a lot of those people who sold us their collections then are trying to buy back the records that they sold us like 25 years ago. And they're trying to sell us their CDs back. And we don't want the CDs back. Secondhand CDs nobody cares about, you know? So yeah, it's changed in that respect, but it's still basically the same thing. It's got its good and bad parts. It's really expensive, but it's kind of a well-known music area, and for the sort of genres that we carry, it was a kind of a hub for those sort of scenes and styles. So you know, it's a good place to be. Running a small business in London is not easy. There's lots of, there's rent rises. You're never sure what's going to happen with rent rises, with rates, with, you know, just changing things like that. It's not easy, but I say it's a sort of labour of love having a record shop, especially if you're doing the kind of stuff that we try and just stock records that we like here, and it's kind of hard like that, to keep up with trends, because things change, styles change, but we kind of don't. Basically, we're kind of stuck with it, with what we do. Well, for us, we go from like 20s blues and country through to sort of 70s punk, but we're probably best known for sort of 50s, early 60s sort of rock and roll, rhythm and blues and stuff. So probably our most sold thing is probably rhythm and blues and rock and roll and rockabilly, I guess. But that's just because that's what we're known for. My favourite kind of music, I've got a sort of wide-ish taste, but I rockabilly and country is, and sort of blues are the things that I was initially into. And then I looked back and I looked forward, so I looked at the things that changed from that, and so you know, but yeah, those things are what I come back to, and ultimately my favourite records. There's a strange bunch. I'm sure most people who've worked in a record shop will tell you that record collectors are strange people, from the nicest people to the weirdest, oddest, strange collecting people who have to have a certain issue of a certain dead wax and have to collect every single issue of that record and stuff. But in general, most people are really enthusiastic, and there's an element of nerdiness about it, but that's good. You kind of have to be nerdy to have a record shop anyway. I can partly understand it, because it's stupid, because I buy loads of records just for stupid covers, but I've never played a record. I might touch a needle on it once, God, it's awful, but it kind of looks funny, or something about it intriguing. But it's kind of weird buying a record and not having a record player to play it on. That kind of seems a bit weird. We get people coming in who say, I haven't even got a record player and I'm buying this. I think, really need a record player to play it on to get the full benefit of it, you know. It's like buying books and being blind or something, you know. It's kind of pointless. There was that thing, and now a lot of the vinyl that we sell is mainly to younger people who are buying records. There's still the older collectors who've carried on collecting, but a lot of those collectors sold their records years ago and have stuck with CDs and not really going back to vinyl. So you know, it's good. record, you know, I wish that somebody would stick to a format, because it's like, Jesus, you kind of spread between the two now. But CDs are, you know, there's definitely a big decline in CDs now. So it's either actually buying records or it's downloads. I've got no problem against downloads. It's up to that, you know. If people really want records, they'll buy records. And if they're buying downloads, then, you know, that's convenient and whatever they want, you know. It just seems weird that you're buying nothing, you know. Picking records over downloads and CDs and radio and stuff, I don't know, there's something, I mean, it's a kind of a thing, you know. Records are a tangible thing that you hold. CDs are as well, but they're kind of boring and small and you don't get the impact from thing. I don't know, there's something about records which is weird. They have some kind of drug-like power over you.